I'm Kirsty McKean from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a fringe. Now, I'm not going to cut my hair, but this nail is called a fringe. I have no idea why it's called a fringe, but apparently it is. Well, we're actually going to do it slightly different. We're going to put my
little... You never would do it the normal way, would you?
We're just going to put my little twist onto it. So, yeah, I'll show you how. So, I'm going to use this nail. We have the gorgeous Cheryl Walker.
Hi.
Hi, everybody. So, I've already prepped this nail. I am just going to give it another clean because we've sat and spoken. I just want to make sure there's absolutely nothing on this nail. So, I'm going to go over and I'm really going to clean around these sides. Cheryl has like a lot of skin at the side that comes up, so the nail kind of sinks into the finger. I've got quite a few clients that have this kind of nail, so I'm making sure that's all clean.
Beautiful. I've never thought about the fact that like people have different fingers, but you guys must see like so many different kinds of fingers. What's the weirdest?
Flat nails.
Flat.
Yeah. Fanned. Yeah. Flat and fanned.
But they narrow at the cuticle, then they come out flatter. Oh, a bit like...
I got like that.
Yeah.
Really?
Can we just...
Maybe
it's calling.
So, if you look at Adam's beautiful, hard-working hands, clearly not, it's too soft. It's very narrow here, and then it's very wide there.
They look like your shell phone.
They do. We could do a beautiful shell on that, wouldn't you?
I'm sure the wife would love that one. She'd love it.
So I'm going to fit a sculpting form. And I'm going to close this end, not completely. I'm going to make a kind of teardrop. And I just want to make that slightly rounder. So I'm just going to put that tool in. Make it less pointy. Yeah, that's better. Give it a wiggle. Press and roll. Press and roll. I'm going to open the back. And we're going to anchor this up slightly. More than that. So, because I'm going to open this out and pull it up, I need to cut out this contact area. So, as I open out and come up, can you see how it's coming away from the nail? So, I'm going to cut this area here just to make it a little bit more flush. Forgetting how big these nails are, but I love them. So if we look at side view, we can see that this anchors up slightly and we get this little valley running through the centre. Close this a little bit more, and we're going to go to about what? How long?
Four.
Four.
Is that okay?
Yeah, I love it. So we're going to a four. I'm going to make sure it's nice and snug at the sides. And now we're going to dehydrate with the nail prep dehydrator. And we're going to use the acid base primer. So I'm going to use natural to do my little platform. So I'm making contact with the nail. Sweeping up. So I'm going to slope up from the 3 to the 4. So when I come up to the 4, I'm going to flatten that off. So you're going to have this angle coming up and then flat at the very tip. So I'm just pinching that a little. I'm just gonna, with this shape, it's gonna have quite a high top to it. So I'm gonna come and bring this bulk down the center first of all. Same again with the next bead. Make sure you blend that back so it's all seamless. Then I'm going to do each side. You still want your cuticle nice and neat. And you're going to pat these sides so they're nice and straight. Because you're going to have a spine that runs here, so it's important to keep patting your product with a nice clean brush on the top and the side to create that spine. Yeah. Then, right at the top, I'm going to add one bead here, slightly round it off, blend it a little, and bring it down, sweep the sides, because we're going to create a circular flat top, so it's going to be flat here, and it's going to be circular here. So it's going to have a circle, or like a half moon top. Blend that together. I'm going to pop the pinching tool on now and give that a little bit of a pinch. I mean, most of the shape will be inlaid through the form fit. Everything that you're building on top will give it the height, but the curve underneath will be the form. Once that's set, you can take that off. So I'm going to file this nail, viewing the side walls first. Do the cuticle area. So you want an angle here and here, both sides, and a flat top here. So the very tip is nice and flat. Now I'm going to buff this. So I'm going to go nice and round and contour that cuticle area. And then flat at the sides. And then flat on top. I'm going to wipe over this with acetone now, and it'll just really clean up the nail, and it'll slightly melt the top surface to make it even smoother. So you can see that shape. That is nice. That is so cool. That's going to be really strong as well. What we're going to do now is use this area here like a stage. We're going to put loads of bling on it and make it the main attraction. So we've got the crystals. Right, so what I'm going to use to adhere these to the nail is the aqua gel. This is It's Clear Dear.
Clear Dear.
So a small amount of that. In my dampened dish, I've got some gel residue wipe off solution. And I'm going to scrape this on. And I'm going to dip my brush into the gel residue wipe off solution. And we're going to... I'm going to tease this down the nail and make it nice and thin. Make sure it doesn't interfere with the shape. Okay, so we've got a nice thin layer right on the top. Then we are going to apply the Urban Graffiti top coat directly over the whole nail. I'm going to do the sides first. And we're going to come over the top of the aqua gel.
Really?
Cheryl looks confused there.
Do you not just stick the gems into the aqua gel?
Because it'll have a sticky layer. So I'll put him there. We're just going to scatter. Make sure you press them into the aqua gel. Now we're going to use some of the micro beads. Just gently touch them into place. I'm just going to brush down these sides again, just so I know that they haven't fouled, like it's not moved, it's not foul. And it also sort of just catching the very sides of that little stage we've done.
Foul?
Like if they've slid. Oh. If they've slid. If they've fallen and slid.
Fell.
If they... It's fell over, Doc. The gel's gone.
Yeah, but you wouldn't say fell over, would you?
Fell over. Yeah. You would if you were in stone.
Do you realise it's a different language here? Pop it's not
that,
English.
Pop that into the Do you like it?
Mm. I do.
It's different, isn't it? Oh. So everything is secure inside the Acrygel and the Urban Graffiti top coat. I'm going to finish off with cuticle oil. So there you are, that's how to do a fringe nail with a bit of pizzazz. So there you are, guys, hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything that I've used today will be listed below, as it always is. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.
Oh, I wonder why you're single.